The following is a special presentation of the National Lacrosse League.
Spring has sprung in Calgary, which means the NLL is also heating up as teams enter the stretch drive. The Colorado Mammoth hit the dome, locked in a battle with the Warriors for the final playoff position in the West and badly needing a victory. The Roughnecks have their eye on a home playoff date, but need to get on a roll to reel in the Seals and the Rush. The Roughnecks host the Mammoth with the NLL on VR Live. And welcome inside Scotiabank Saddledome, where tonight the 6-6 Calgary Roughnecks host the 3-8 Colorado Mammoth in a big West Division matchup in the National Lacrosse League. Good evening, thanks for joining us. My name is Grant Farhall with Ryan Ballantyne, set to bring you tonight's NLL tilt here on BR Live. And Ryan, it's an intriguing matchup. The Calgary Roughnecks historically have been known as a team that scores a pile of goals. This season they've been winning through defense and goaltending, facing a team tonight struggling to find those goals.
Yeah, the Calgary Roughnecks have all of their wins, their opponents have scored 10 goals or less this season. Christian Del Bianco doing a wonderful job in the net. And as we take a look at the standings here, you see that the Roughnecks are those two games behind, or one game behind the Seals and the Rush, with that game in hand going the other way for the Rush and the Seals. So the Roughnecks are going to need help from other teams in the NLL as they try and climb the West Division standings. On the other side, the Mammoth are trailing the Warriors right now at 3-8. A win tonight would take a big step towards getting closer to that playoff berth.
Now, as mentioned, to do that, they're going to need some goals tonight. And so far this season, the main offensive weapon has been Eli McLaughlin.
Yeah, as we take a look at Eli McLaughlin from this season, 28 goals so far on the year. He's really the only one filling the net for the Mammoth so far this season with 52 points. The next highest leading scorer on this team has just 33 points and 15 goals. So the offense runs through McLaughlin, and you can be sure that the Roughnecks defense will be keying on number 51.
Now with the Calgary Roughnecks, again, they've been winning through defense, but offensively, Dane Doby, the veteran, stands on the verge of a milestone, just one goal short of 400. And Ryan, he's enjoying arguably one of his most consistent and best seasons.
Well, not only is Dane Doby having a great season this year, it has been a consistent career where Dane Doby's put up goals on goals on goals. But this year so far, 72 points heading into this season on 28 goals and 44 assists. Everything has been running through number 44 all season. And with the early season missing, with Wes Berg still not in the lineup, everybody knew that Dane Doby would have to step up this season. He's certainly done that. And as you mentioned, 399 goals on the record book so far for Dane Doby, the all-time assist leader, the all-time goals leader, the all-time points leader, of course, for the Calgary Roughnecks.
And earlier tonight, he caught up with Kayla Spies.
Dane, you guys scored 15 goals last week. You only got one goal, and your teammate Curtis Dixon didn't get any. Did you guys switch any things up on the offensive side of the ball to spread out the scoring?
Not necessarily. I think guys just came to play, and we just played what the defense gave us. And, you know, Curtis was feeding the ball really well last game, and you know, he's such a dynamic player. He could do a bit of everything, and we need him to feed the ball, and he does a really good job at it.
Now, I know you don't like talking about yourself, but have you reflected on the milestone that you're coming up on, one goal away from 400?
Not there yet. You know, we're just going out here trying to win a lacrosse game here. It's a very important game, divisional series on the line, and, you know, we got to take care of home floor here, and if it comes, it comes, but win's more important right now.
Thanks a lot for this.
Yeah, thanks.
It's the Calgary Roughnecks and the Colorado Mammoth coming up next on VR Live.
With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north, strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God, keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you very much, Annie, and happy birthday.
NLL on BR Live is brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com to see how much you could save. Welcome back inside Scotiabank Saddledome. My name's Grant Forhall with Ryan Ballantyne. On the floor tonight, Kayla Spies set to bring you all the action here between the Roughnecks and the Mammoth. The goaltending matchup tonight in net for Colorado. No surprise there. Dylan Ward, 3-7 on the year, 11.38 goals against average, and a save percentage of 76.1%. At the other end of the floor, he'll be opposed by Christian Del Bianco, the young number one netminder for the Roughnecks, 6-6 with a sparkling 10.91 goals against average and a 78.5 save percentage. And Ryan, Christian Del Bianco, I think you could make an argument that so far this season is the Roughnecks MVP.
Well, I don't even think you need to make an argument. Dane Doby leading the way offensively with 72 points. But if Del Bianco and the defense around him don't do the job that they're doing, Calgary's got a couple fewer wins, and they're looking a whole lot like the Mammoth in record. Calgary's got a couple wins this season where Del Bianco's given up 5 goals in 2 of the wins this year, and that was an 8-5 win and a 9-5 win, so not enough offense that would typically provide a victory, but nevertheless, the Roughnecks came away with a win on those nights.
Faceoff matchup will probably be for the bulk of this contest. Tyler Burton, 55% on the draw so far this season. He'll face Tim Edwards just behind him at 54%, so a pretty even matchup there as we are just about to get underway here tonight. The Roughnecks standing with that 6-6 record, third in the West, but within striking distance of the Rush and the Seals. The Mammoth head-to-head with Vancouver for that final playoff position. And first possession of the game will go to the Roughnecks, wearing those special St. Paddy Day's jerseys here this evening, as they do every time they play a game on this holiday. And they look sharp, Ryan.
Yeah, they do. And just want to mention, of course, that you can get your hands on those jerseys. Check out Elevate Auctions, as these jerseys will go for charity after the game.
Doby looking for goal number 500. One short passes over to Dixon. Dixon takes a shot. Stick was checked just as he did, so it went well over the net. And now here come the Mammoth in transition. Long, loopy pass gets to Tim Edwards. And now he's going to get the ball in the hands of the offense, including Jacob Roué. Roué goes back and forth, and they're waiting to get the full offense on the floor. They do now. Lee passes over, and now they'll work it from the far side with 12 to shoot early in this game. There's a shot, and it somehow goes wide of the net from point-blank range. And now here come the Roughnecks back in transition.
Yeah, quick pass in the center there, but unfortunately the shooter unable to get the ball on target.
So now the Roughnecks will get their opportunity as we look for our first goal of this contest. Taylor passes over to the far side to Dixon, back to Taylor. Back to Dixon now with 7 to shoot. Dixon passes into the slot area. Behind the back shot just goes wide. And that'll give the Mammoth possession back on the 32nd violation. Sullivan steps over center for the Mammoth. And now he'll pass off and head off the floor. As that's Kyle Killen, the rookie. One of the real strong rookies this year in the NLL. Now here's an opportunity, and Christian Del Bianco makes his first save of the game off of Jeff Whitting, who had 2-2 in his NLL debut a week ago. And now the Roughnecks will go back to work offensively. Riley Lowen had a hat trick last game. He passes this time. And eventually it comes to Pace. Pace has been a real offensive force when healthy this season for the Roughnecks. And now here's Lowen again with five to shoot. Doesn't like his options. Passes up high. Here comes the shot. Save made there. First save of the game for Dylan Ward. And now the Mammoth in transition. Have some numbers coming down the floor. Here comes the shot. Scores! Robert Hope in transition. Colorado leads 1-0.
Well, and credit Joey Capito here as he cleared out the Roughnecks defender and gave Hope the straight run right at the goalie. As we'll get a look at the replay here, you can see Capito just knocked out two Roughnecks as Dan Taylor and Dan McRae were both back there.
But yeah, there's three Roughnecks back there, actually.
Capito wiped out two of them and gave Robert Hope a clean look. He made no mistake and opened the scoring.
So that's the type of start that the Mammoth need and were hoping for. And as a result, they lead this one 1-0. And possession off the faceoff will go right back to the Roughnecks. And the captain, Dan McRae, starts it off. McRae opened the scoring last Saturday for the Roughnecks. This time he gives it to Riley Lowen. Lowen now passes up high to Dixon. And now here's Pace with it. Swings it over to Dobie. Dobie now to the net. Now turns back, but behind the back pass, didn't find Lowen, and now potential break opportunity here again for the Mammoth in transition. It's Gillis with it, defense back though, takes the shot, Del Bianco safe, rebound is there, and Hope skips it up for the Mammoth to recover it, but then turned over, nice defense there by Simpson, who then loses it. Hot potato ball right now. Bell's gonna try and chase it down to the corner. Oh, he's crushed into the boards by John Lentz, who is gonna have a seat.
Yeah, that was a big hit along the boards here. Tyson Bell just gets wiped out by Lentz. And he'll go to the box. We'll see what the official call is.
I think they're going to call it interference.
Well, they might have called it boarding. Yeah, 2 minutes for boarding. Lentz not happy about the call. He's having a discussion with the official about it. But he'll sit for 2 minutes or less, as Tyson Bell was trying to hunt down that loose ball.
Calgary power play 43.5% on the season. They did get five a week ago. Penalty kill for the Mammoth, 51.6. Now Dobie with it. Dobie plays it up high. Now they'll work it to Dixon. Dixon back to Dobie, gets by him, gets it off the wall. There's a shot. That was from Dutch. Didn't get anywhere near the net though. And now once again, the Mammoth trying to push the action in transition. Dan Coates down to the corner, going to recover it there. Calgary back on defense with a minute 28 remaining in the power play as the Mammoth will look to kill off some of that remaining 90 seconds. Here's Rouet with it. Rouet now, well defended. Still has 10 to shoot though, hangs on to it, now double teamed. Going to go behind the net, loses the ball briefly, and does a nice job of killing the remaining portion of that 30 second clock.
Yeah, at that point, just looking to take some time away from this Roughnecks power play unit. And Rouet, despite losing the handle on it momentarily, did get it back. Kept that 30-second clock alive.
54 seconds remaining in the power play. Dobie looks up to check that. Now he starts to look towards the net. Passes off. Now Dutch with it. He goes behind that. Stuff attempt, scores! What a goal there by Curtis Dixon. And we're tied up 1-1.
Well, we heard from Kayla in that pregame interview last week. It was Dane Dobie and Curtis Dixon combining for one goal between them, and it was Dixon with the goose egg. He gets off the schneid here early, just over 4.5 minutes gone in the first, to Dixon's on the board with his first of the night on a stuff attempt from his office.
Yeah, Dixon last week, an atypical but effective game with those eight assists and then the fight. And
actually
now leads the team in penalty minutes.
Yeah, 17 minutes in penalties on that fight for Curtis Dixon. I talked to him this week. He said, nobody's gonna do that to my roommate and get away with it, as Dan McRae had taken a cross check to the head moment before.
Now the Roughnecks seeking their first lead of the game. Taylor passes off to Dixon, the goal scorer. Dixon now finds Pace. Pace looking for a lane to the net, can't find one, try to move, drop the ball, and Ward comes up and gets the ball back, plays it well ahead to Gillis. He's got a man ahead of the play. Didn't see him, though. Or maybe thought the defense was back. Now there's a shot, and Delbianco goes post to post to take one away from the Mammoth.
And nice stop there from the Riggers goalie.
That was on the newcomer, Vitarelli. That big recent trade that the Mammoth made. A couple trades recently ahead of the deadline. Now Dobie with it for the Roughnecks. Dobie passes off this time to Lowen off the bench. Lowen swings it down low. And the Roughnecks work it out of the corner. Eventually comes to Dobie. Dobie trying to cut to the net. Backhand shot, and Ward denies Dobie of number 400. 9:30 to go here. First quarter, 1-1 your score. And the Mammoth now with possession. Enter the Calgary end. Rouet has it once again. Rouet now swings it over to the far side with 14 to shoot. Now the Mammoth trying to cut towards the net. Oh, all alone there in front was Jeff Whitting, but he couldn't find the pass. Vitarelli missed him. Now Lee just swings it down to the corner, and Calgary takes it back on the 30-second violation. 1-1 your score. The Calgary Roughnecks and Mammoth in a tight one early in the first quarter. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. It's a 1-1 game here as the Calgary Roughnecks are taking a look here at some of the top producing offense for them, with Dane Dobie leading the way, 28 goals on the season. Reese Dutch, the offseason acquisition, coming in with 21. Curtis Dixon missed the first three games of this season, still has 16 goals for the Roughnecks, doing their work here in the beginning of, or throughout the course of this season. 12 games in now, 6 to play, and Dane Dobie still on pace for one of his best offensive seasons. And when we take a look at the Mammoth, it's quite the different story, as you see Eli McLaughlin up top with 28 goals. The second player on that list, Lee, having 15, and Rouet with just 11. So not a lot of scoring at the top or bottom of this Mammoth lineup. And if they're going to win tonight, they're going to need those three players to pick it up offensively. Roughnecks with possession, but they turn it over. And now the Mammoth, who have been really running the floor in transition, here they come again. Coates with it. Coates passes off this time to Edwards. Edwards has a man, but Wardle didn't like that look, so now he'll take it to the corner and let the offense get on the floor to join him. Still has 15 to shoot this time. Wardle now looks for his options, finds a man, and eventually it comes over to Killen. Now they'll work it over to the far side. Now here's an opportunity. Fake shot, takes the shot, and Delbianco makes a nice stop.
Yeah, Delbianco very active in the Calgary net. You can see him kind of going from side to side there, making sure to keep the save and the rebound where his defense can pick it up, limit the opportunities, and take away second chances.
Shots on goal right now favoring Colorado to the tune of 6-3. Now Dobie has a man. Lowen shoots and scores. Riley Lowen, off the nice feed from Dobie, makes it 2-1 Roughnecks.
Yeah, Dane Dobie here, the nice flip pass back to Lowen, right in the slot area, and able to put it past Dylan Ward to get the Roughnecks their first lead of the night, as you see Dobie cutting towards the net. Just a nice little over-the-shoulder flip back, and Riley Lowen has found himself some space, however temporarily, before getting pushed to the floor on that play. But as we see here, a 2-1 game for the Calgary Roughnecks over the Colorado Mammoth in this rubber match meeting between the two clubs.
A similar goal to what we saw last week, Ryan, where Dobie and Dixon drew so much attention, so they just started to look for the open man. Really unselfish play, and it really worked last week. And so far tonight, it's working as well. Calgary leading this one 2-1. They also now have possession here. Dobie with it. Now he starts to move towards the net, getting some help from Taylor, who'll go over to the other side, gets it back. Dobie takes the shot, looking for that corner, and I think Ward got a piece of it.
Yeah, Ward got the elbow up.
7:19 to go here in the first quarter. Mammoth trailing now for the first time in this one, 2-1. But now looking to get back on even ground. Lee with it. Lee now passes off. Here comes the shot, save made by Delbianco off of Kyle Killen. Killen gets his own rebound, though, and now he'll swing it, and they'll work it from the other side. Looking for this second possession opportunity, and a spill and happen away from the ball, and now we get a whistle as the Roughnecks are trying to break free there, but I think we actually have a penalty.
Yeah, it looks like Colorado's going to the box.
Delay a game. Did he kick the ball or touch the ball there? Is that what happened?
I mean, that must be what happened. I'm not quite sure. I mean, obviously, when the whistle blows, you have to drop the ball immediately where it is, and that must not be what happened there, as Colorado finds themselves sitting for two or less, winning on the delay of game.
Power play 1-for-1. Dolby takes the shot, and Ward makes a nice stop. Now a long pass. Oh, beautiful pass there all the way to Coates. And the Mammoth now once again working shorthanded for another minute, 35 seconds. Rue has it. Rue passes off. This time Wardle now moves over to the other side. But now 7 to shoot. Oh, nice pass across. Couldn't find Wardle. Well defended there by Manning, who just got back in the lineup a week ago after missing the longest stretch of his career due to a lower body injury that was really troubling him, but he looks back and healthy now. Riley Lowen with it now on the power play. Another 70 seconds for the Roughnecks on this PP. Dobie now has it. Plays it up high, gets it back with 15 to shoot. Looks across the other side. Oh, nice pass by Dixon. Lowen couldn't handle it though. Had to go to the corner, now walks out with it, plays it up high to Hayes, over to the side, scores! Beautiful power play work there. Dutch finishes it off, and the Roughnecks lead 3-1. Ryan, that's the identical goals we saw a week ago.
Yeah, I was just going to say, last week the Roughnecks were incredibly successful at drawing the goaltender up to challenge the shooter, turning it into a backdoor pass, and finding that empty foot and a half between the goaltender and his post. It worked to perfection last week, and they're doing it again here tonight. We saw the attempted pass on that same play to Riley Lowen from Curtis Dixon moments before, and Reese Dutch catches it, puts it in the back of the net, makes it 3-1 Roughnecks.
And you can also start to see this offense finding chemistry, Ryan. They didn't have all their people together for the start of the season, missing Dixon, and Pace was injured. Now this unit's really starting to gel.
Yeah, you look at that top five, and they're really putting things together.
Now here's Bell with a shot and a save by Ward. Rebound is there. Put home by Currier, but it will not count. Foot in the crease.
And Coach Miloski has the challenge flag in his hand. He wants to see a replay, and it looks like it's not close enough. No, he puts the challenge flag back in his pocket.
Now Rue takes a shot from well out, handled by Del Bianco, and Simpson all over that loose ball. Shane Simpson, the top draft pick of the Roughnecks in the last draft. I believe 6th overall, passes off, and now Dobie has it once again. Skips sideways into the Colorado zone. Now the Roughnecks work it from the right side. Benchley comes back to Dobie with 7 to shoot. Dobie now, still with it, hangs on, turns, fires, hits a body. He hit his own man, Dan Taylor, and that's a 30-second violation against the Roughnecks. So the Colorado Mammoth will take possession back here, trailing now the Roughnecks 3-1 here tonight at Scotiabank Saddledome. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
Welcome back to the Scotiabank Saddledome. Coach, tonight is the last game in the season series. How much emphasis do you put that on tonight's game plan?
Well, the magnitude of the game goes without being said, but, you know, we still got to stick to our five-minute segments and play within the process. The outcome takes care of ourselves, but we know what's on the line.
You guys obviously have the lead right now. I want to talk about the defense for a second. Their first goal came on the transition. Is that an area that you want to tighten up on?
Well, absolutely. These guys are built on transition and power play. So if we play a straight five-on-five game in the blood and the beer, and that's our game, we'll be successful. So we just got to limit those opportunities, and we'll be all right.
Thanks a lot, Coach.
Thanks.
Guys, back up to you.
Thanks, Kayla. Yeah, Kurt Miloski happy with what he's seen so far. 4:45 to go here, first quarter, 3-1. His team leading the Mammoth. Mammoth now have possession, looking to take a bite out of that lead. Wardle has it. plays it down to the corner for Eli McLaughlin. McLaughlin now up high to Lee. Lee gets it in the hands of Killen, who goes back to McLaughlin. Now Killen takes a shot from well out, misses that post, and it goes into the Roughneck bench. That'll give Calgary possession back. And the Roughnecks pass it over center. Dobie with it. Dobie now gives it to Dutch. Dutch going to go down to Dixon in the corner. Swings it all the way on the other side to Dobie. Now with 15 to shoot, Dobie looking at his options. Finds a man up high, gets it back, takes the shot, scores! There it is! Dane Dobie, number 400 of his career.
A great give and go with Curtis Dixon going back and forth before finding the five hole on Dylan Ward. Dane Dobie, a beauty pass, a beauty goal, and you can see the smile of relief on his face as that milestone falls. Number 400 for number 44. Just an incredible career so far for Dane Dobie, and it continues here as he gets the 400th goal of his NLL career.
29th on this season for Dane Dobie, and it also gives his team the 4-1 lead. Mammoth get possession off the faceoff. Rouet has it. Rouet plays it down to the corner. As the Mammoth now find themselves trailing by three, they're gonna have to get something happen here. Oh, there's a nice goal, but it will not count. Diving across the crease was Jeff Whitting, but he stepped in the crease. Now Courier was looking for a breakaway pass. Can't find it. Dan McRae comes over to help him though. And now they'll leave the floor and get the offense back down there. The Roughnecks offense really started to roll last week, and they've continued that momentum here tonight, as they've got four in the first quarter so far and still 3:25 to go. There's a shot, nice save there by Dylan Ward, who has given up four on now nine shots, but not really any that you can fault him for. Now here's Lee for the Mammoth to Wardle. Pardon me, that was Killen with it. Killen gets it back. Now he goes across the other side to Wardle. Wardle and Killen go back and forth. Nice passing on this possession for the Mammoth. They've only got five to shoot. Oh, nearly deflects to the goal. Nice defense there by the Roughnecks with 2:50 to go. Now they push it down the floor. Simpson has it here for the Riggers. They'll give it to Dane Dobie. Dobie now has a man. That's Dan Taylor with 13 to shoot. Taylor goes across to the right side. But now just seven to shoot. There's a shot in on Ward. He squeezes it and then falls back on, but has the ball under him. Spend your Saturday nights at the Rough House. For all your ticket options, visit calgaryroughnecks.com/tickets. Come for the party, stay for the game. 2:15 to go here, first quarter. Calgary leading this one 4-1, and there's some more good defense there by Dan McRae as he just steps in the way of that pass, picks it off, and now comes down the floor with Courier. Courier now staring at a 2-on-1, so he's just going to wait for the offense before giving it to Riley Lowen, who has one in this quarter, as does Dane Dobie, who passes over to Curtis Dixon, who also has one goal. Dixon now takes a shot. Changed the angle on that one. Nice save there by Ward. And now a battle up against the wall. Pace in there, trying to keep it alive. But nice job there by the Mammoth to finally get possession with just over 90 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Lintz did that good work. He passes off and goes to the bench. And now here's Lee with it. Swings it across to Whitting. Whitting now trying to find a lane to the net. Nearly stepped in the crease. Now looking for a man, and once again, the Roughnecks just pick it off. As you can see, Ryan, the Colorado Mammoth just struggling to find quality opportunities.
Yeah, really trying to, struggling to move the ball, and again, Calgary's defense giving up the fewest goals per game in the league right now, and there's a reason for that, not just Christian DelBianco, but the defense itself, collapsing the guys, covering guys correctly, getting their stick in the way of passes. They've done it all here so far tonight, and they've been doing it all season.
Now there's an opportunity shot, save made by DelBianco. VR Live makes watching live sports easy. Download or visit to watch all of the National Lacrosse League action and more with VR Live. There's a shot from well out from the Mammoth off the end wall right into the waiting hands of the Roughnecks, and it's pushed ahead to Bell. Bell steps over center, and now Calgary will go to work with under 30 seconds to go. Del Bianco was looking to the bench. Looks like he's going to stay in there, though. 17 seconds, 13 seconds on the shot clock, so there's about a 3-second differential. That's probably why he's standing in his net. But Calgary's going to try and wind this down as much as possible. Dobie now has it, passes over to the other side. Wicked shot just goes wide, and the Mammoth will have about 3.8 seconds to work with here. And they'll put the goalie on the bench and try and draw something up here. And now here's an opportunity. Oh, stripped Courier with the wonderful defense there, as it looked like Capito had a lane to the net. But Courier said, uh-uh. Del Bianco and the Calgary Roughnecks leading the Mammoth 4-1 at the end of the first quarter. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
The Calgary Roughnecks lead the Colorado Mammoth 4-1 with help from that man right there, Dane Dobie, who scored his 400th career goal. And as you take a look again at the consistency of Dane Dobie, no fewer than 26 goals on a season, and those seasons were somewhat injury plagued as well, as Dane Dobie routinely over 30 and climbing even once over 50 goals here in his career as he gets towards 400 National Lacrosse League goals. We can take a look at some of the stats from the first quarter in this one. The edge on scoreboard, of course, 4-1, as well as shots 11-10 in favor of the Roughnecks. They've also taken 4 out of 6 of the faceoffs so far, and also shooting the ball off target as well, leading in pretty much every category there in the first quarter.
Well, and I think what that doesn't tell, Ryan, is that when you look at the 11-10 shots, it's nominal in terms of the edge. But really, for the most part, the Mammoth had maybe one or two what I would consider to be high-quality opportunities. The rest of those shots from well out.
And in transition as well.
Yeah, absolutely. So
their only goal in that first quarter, Duke did come off the stick of Robert Hope. That was a transition opportunity. Joey Capito cleared out the defense, and it was Robert Hope putting it over the shoulder of Del Bianco.
Well, we heard Kurt Miloski talk about that this is a team that gets it done on the power play and in transition. They want to have this to be a 5-on-5 game, and they feel if they can keep it 5-on-5, the Roughnecks have a good chance of winning here tonight. And so far, it's working to the tune of 4-1. Pace now for the Roughnecks has it. Pace looking to work around his man. Said passes off to Dane Dobie, back to Dutch now. Dutch goes behind the net, stuff attempt, scores! Dan Taylor making like Curtis Dixon and gives the Roughnecks a 5-1 lead.
Yeah, 26 jumps out from behind the back of the net on the nice feed here from Reese Dutch. And Taylor faked the stuff initially and then went for it after the fact. And he kind of faked out Ward before putting it over his shoulder for the goal. And that's Dan Taylor making it a 5-1 game on his 14th of the year.
Yeah, providing that valuable secondary scoring. You look at the work by Dan Taylor and Riley Lowen and Tyler Pace taking some of that load off of the big three. And particularly the last couple of games, that's really been balanced scoring for the Roughnecks. And that they lead this one 5-1 now. The Mammoth need to start to go to work offensively. McLaughlin has it. That pass eludes Lee, and right away the Roughnecks turn it over.
No surprise, Zach Courier scooping that loose ball for the Roughnecks.
Manning now with it. Manning plays it over to the bench, but
it's going to be too many men.
That was an easy call, I would say.
Yeah, Reese Dutch wasn't even all the way off the bench.
And I think he knew it too as soon as he saw that ball coming to him. He was like, ah.
Yeah, uh-oh. and I mean, I had thought that the defender was in the box, but I'm not sure that Dutch was all the way off the bench. We can take a look at it here. As we see in the replay here, the ball goes over, And you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 Roughnecks in shot. Dutch is the fifth, but I mean, his foot's still on the bench when he catches the ball. The wide shot may have shown the defender in or out of that red substitution area, but nevertheless, it'll be the Mammoths on the power play.
That power play, 43.5% on the season. Calgary has the number one PK at 64.2. Now 10 to shoot. Here's McLaughlin with it. Takes a shot off the bar, I think.
Yeah, rips it off the post, which avoids the over and back and gives the Mammoth another possession.
You can see he hit that post so hard that the whole net jarred. But doesn't count, so the Mammoth back down the floor, still in the power play. Another post, this time from Ryan Lee as he hits the other one.
Well, you know what they say, Grant, it's that the postman always rings twice. And so far on the power play, it's proven to be true.
Well, for a team struggling to find goals right now, that's some bad luck. McLaughlin with it once again, gets the ball back. Now 18 to shoot, still plenty of time on this possession. There's the shot, scores! Kyle Killen injecting some offense here. Had 2 goals a week ago, gets his 3rd here in his 2nd game, and now it's 5-2.
Yeah, Killen just ripped this one 5-hole past Del Bianco, who got down but not fast enough to prevent that power play goal and make it a 5-2 game.
And I will immediately correct myself. It was Jeff Whitting making his NLL debut. Kyle Killen has been killing it all year as he's got 15 goals now as a rookie. So my apologies for that error. Killen's really doing a good job here for the Mammoth, and he's got them back to within 3 here, 5-2. Faceoff contested. Looks like the Roughnecks are going to take it, though, right away, as they've had the edge so far on faceoffs and looking for the immediate response here. As they're now only up by 3, Doby has it, directing traffic. Now Dixon with it. Dixon, hard pass over to Doby, couldn't handle it. A little too hot, but he recovers it. Now his hard pass over to the near side to Pace. Pace now trying to get around the defender, takes the shot, nearly found the near post. And that'll be a 30-second violation against the Roughnecks.
Yeah, good defense there from the Mammoth, keeping the Roughnecks to the outside, not allowing them to collapse towards the net.
So now Colorado a chance to make this an even tighter game. They get the offense back out there. Here's Whitting, nice move to the net, and he just put it high over the crossbar after a beautiful one-on-one move. And now here's Simpson in transition for the Roughnecks. Taking some whacks. And now has help off the bench. Calgary a little slow to get all the offense on the floor this time, but Dutch has it for the Roughnecks. Dutch, looking at his options, decides to go to Riley Lowen. Lowen finds Doby with 7 to shoot. Doby finds Dixon now. Hard pass, goes all the way to the corner, and Josh Sullivan happy to take it off the wall and head down the floor.
I think Dixon was looking for Dan Taylor on that backdoor style play, but was unable to connect.
So now the Mammoth looking to edge closer. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Vitarelli has it now. Vitarelli plays it to McLaughlin. McLaughlin now has a man shot. Del Bianco makes the save on Jacob Rouet. Now all the way down the floor to Manning. Manning has a 2-on-1. Manning to the net, takes the shot and just misses. Mammoth Lacrosse returns to the Loud House next Saturday, March 23rd at 7 p.m. to take on the Vancouver Warriors. Speaking of Warriors, it will be Military Appreciation Night. Be there as the Mammoth organization and faithful fans honor the brave men and women for their service and dedication to the United States military. Check it out at coloradomammoth.com. Courier was trying to get a chance there in transition. Now he's being pinned down by 3 members of the Mammoth, and they take the ball away. Whitting now has it with 10:30 to go here in the second quarter. 5-2, Calgary up by 3. Huey has it. Now he passes off. And the Mammoth working from the right side. Now McLaughlin has it on the left. Penalty coming upcoming to the Roughnecks, so Ward to the bench, and the Mammoth will work the 6-on-5. As they get the extra attacker out there, McLaughlin takes the shot, hit a body, and as the Roughnecks touch it, it'll be, looks like Chad Cummings going to the box.
Yeah, Eli Salama wasn't happy after he got the ball. He took an extra whack. thought that the official should have seen it.
Colorado 1-for-1 on the power play. And looked really effective. And again, we heard Kurt Malosky describe this team as being a power play team. So Calgary wants to stay out of the box, but they've gone in twice this quarter so far. See if the Mammoth can make them pay again. Killen's playing the highest position, goes back and forth with McLaughlin. Now they start to edge their way towards the net. McLaughlin with it. Pass gets through everybody. Now he gets it back from the other side. McLaughlin with it. Has a man open. There's the shot. Save made by Del Bianco. Rebound gathered in, though, by Killen to keep the power play out on the floor with a minute 33 still to go on it. McLaughlin has it. McLaughlin has a man. Now here's the pass up high. Shot saved by Del Bianco. Rebound is there, and Del Bianco makes another save, and it sits under him. And we get a whistle on the play here as Del Bianco makes a couple big stops as his team has a minute 22 remaining on the Mammoth power play. 5-2 Calgary leading. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
Welcome back to the Scotiabank Saddle Dome. I'm joined by Pat Quill of the Mammoth. Pat, I asked Kurt the exact same question. I want to hear from you. How important is tonight's game? It's the last game in the season series.
It's big for that, but it's big more for us, how we're going to finish this season off. To me, that's like every game for us is huge, no matter who our opponent is.
Your last goal came on the power play. There was two posts and then the goal. You guys are in the middle of a power play right now. How crucial are these special teams?
Huge. They've already scored twice on their power play, so we need to match them here.
Thanks all for this.
Thank you.
Guys, back up to you.
Thanks, Kayla. Yeah, big opportunity right now for the Mammoth to make this one a little bit closer. They've got a minute 22 to go on their power play, but Calgary will have possession here when play is whistled in. And yeah, for the Mammoth, it's basically the playoffs right now, as again, they got this game tonight, and then they have a home and home against the Vancouver Warriors. One of those teams is going to get that fourth and final playoff spot in the West in those next two games. If one team sweeps those, that's going to be a big leg up for them. But I have a feeling that race is going to go right down to the wire. Calgary now working shorthanded, just 5 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Dixon's just going to try and throw it down to the corner, and the Mammoth will take over here with 51 seconds left to work with on the power play. Coates has it for Colorado. He swings it ahead to Killen. Out there with Whitting. They go back and forth, and now it's going to come to McLaughlin with 15 to shoot. McLaughlin gets it back, takes the shot, hits a body right in front of him. That might have been Manning it went off of. Mammoth get it back, though. Here's McLaughlin again. This time he's over the net. Ball is loose in the slot area, scooped up there nicely by the Roughnecks, and off and running is Eli Salama. He's going to pull up and wait for reinforcements. Has some help off the bench. Calgary should be able to kill off the remainder of this PK as they're down to just 5 seconds. Cummings standing up. He'll immediately race to the bench. And Calgary will have just a few seconds to work with, but they're happy to just get back to 5-on-5 across here. Dane Doby with it. Throws it to Dutch, nowhere near him. And now the Mammoth will take back over here. 7:53 to go in the second quarter, 5-2. Calgary leading this one. Hope has it. He opened the scoring in this one way back early in the first quarter. Now Wardle with it for the Mammoth. Has help off the bench. Killen has it once again. And then ball is loose in the crease area, picked off there by the Roughnecks. And here they come down the floor once again. There's a pass. Oh, shot just got through. Off of pace. Ward got enough of it, so it skipped wide. Calgary, though, Bell recovered the loose ball to give his team the fresh 30. He hears it from the bench as he comes over. Now Dixon on the floor. Dixon passes to Taylor. Taylor passes off, and now it comes to Dutch. Army, that was Pace to the slot. Shot there was interrupted. Nice defense there by the Mammoth, who now look ahead down the floor with exactly 7 minutes to go here in the first half. 5-2 Calgary with the 3-goal lead. Mammoth now. Whitting tried the shot, hit the shin of his own man. And now the Roughnecks have numbers. Mammoth get back out on D very quickly. Simpson has it. Wines fires right into the chest of Ward. Rebound is there briefly, but he finds it. Rainbow pass all the way down the floor. 2-on-1 for the Mammoth in transition. Nice passing, but Lee was unable to control it, flying through the crease.
Yeah, maybe one pass too many there, yeah. As Lee was behind the goal line when he was trying to receive that pass, which is not a high percentage opportunity, despite the evidence to the contrary here tonight with behind the goal line shots.
Got two of them for the Roughnecks so far on stuff plays. Now here's Dutch with it from well out. His shot's deflected, bounces wide of the net, and the Mammoth get the loose ball. And they'll push it down the floor with 6 minutes now to go. Taylor Stewart with it. He has Wardle now. Wardle runs down the near side now with some room through the defense. Wardle takes the shot and bounces it just right wide of the far post.
Well, and you wonder when you've got Ryan Benesch traded and Eli McLaughlin kind of leading the way offensively, who's going to step up and be that next guy in this new-look Mammoth offense.
5:30 to go here in the second quarter. Pass through the slot area, but there was a Roughneck player on the floor. They recover it. Now Lowen with a move. Lowen to the net, takes the shot. A nice save there by Ward. Don't miss the NLL's newest show, NLL Flash, hosted by Tyson Geik, taking a closer look at the NLL's hottest topics and takes from an all-star cast of analysts from across North America every Wednesday at 7 p.m. Eastern on NLL.com. 5:03 to go here, second quarter, Calgary leading 5-2. As the game has settled in here in the late stages of this second frame, Dutch now passes up high to Lowen. Dane Doby with it. Doby now has Dutch. Dutch with a nice move. Goes to the backhand, shot in on Ward, makes the save, and the Mammoth recover.
Yeah, the Mammoth defense is really tightened up, not giving the Roughnecks offense any room to shoot over the last couple possessions.
And now here's McLaughlin, the leading scorer for the Mammoth. McLaughlin passes off now with 10 to shoot. And now here's an opportunity. There's a backhand try by Vittorelli, save made by Del Bianco, and then a big pile up in the crease, but cooler heads will prevail. Calgary continues to lead this one by 3-5-2 over the Colorado Mammoth. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
Well, taking a look at the Colorado bench, some changes made in Denver. Ian Lord and Corey Vittorelli coming in, Ryan Benesch and Rowan Kelly being shipped out ahead of the trade deadline in the last week or so. And Vittorelli in just his second game in for the Mammoth here. They're down 5-2, their offense has been struggling. Then they went out and just saw if they could maybe trade something up and get another grit guy.
Everyone was trading with Rochester. Vittorelli. I mean, Rochester was just open for business.
Yes.
Just making a wholesale number of changes that involved almost everybody else in the league. Making the weeks in advance of the deadline really active in a way that you don't usually see.
No.
But yeah, Colorado part of that fun. And you can see they're still maybe trying to click offensively. Vittorelli, a good player, but probably will take some time to gel with his teammates. Now that pass across for the Roughnecks doesn't work, and Sullivan grabs it there for the Mammoth and pushes it down the floor quickly. 3:49 to go here in the first half. Calgary continues to lead 5-2 on the strength of four goals in the first quarter. Now here's Wardle for the Mammoth. Wardle passes off, now 14 on the shot clock. There's the shot, save made off of Jacob Rouet. Recovered nicely, though, there by Wardle for the Mammoth to give his team second opportunity here. Another shot from well out, whistles past the net, and that'll give Calgary possession back. It's going to roll all the way down the floor, so it'll be over and back against Colorado.
And Calgary will take the ball with 30 seconds, a fresh 30, trying to reestablish what was a four-goal lead.
Pace has it here for the Roughnecks. He gets a nice hard pick from Dixon, then try to find him, and it was all the way to Dylan Ward nearly fooled him, and he just got in the way of it at the last minute. Now here's Stewart for the Mammoth with exactly three to go here in the first half. Mammoth would love to make this one a little tighter heading into the locker room. There's an opportunity, scores! Just like that, Ryan Lee found an open seam and makes it 5-3. The Mammoth all of a sudden back to within just two.
And Ryan Lee has got some words for the Roughneck defender. I believe it was Simpson that came in after him. But a nice pass and feed there to Ryan Lee. And yeah, you can see he got walked over a little bit after the goal. But Ryan Lee brings it to a 5-3 game and reduces that lead to just two with 2:52 to play in quarter number two.
Well, and that's the thing, is it's felt like a game that the Roughnecks have generally been in control of, but it's now just down to a two-goal lead, so a very plucky effort from the Colorado Mammoth here, a game they desperately want to have. Face-off contested, Courier had a chance of it. Oh, a big high stick there. Here's an opportunity for the Mammoth, scores! Dan Coates all alone, and it's 5-4. The Mammoth are back to within one.
Yeah, Dan Coates here, just standing right on top of the crease, gets a nice feed on the delayed penalty call and finds that top corner over the shoulder of Christian DelBianco. Not a lot of guys, when you give them that much time in front of the net, aren't going to score, and he had a lot of time. The Mammoth captain makes it a one-goal deficit now on the 23rd shot of the first half for the Mammoth.
Well, and the play broke down there as you could hear the high stick from Courier that was delayed on the delay call, and Coach just went down there, and no one guarded him whatsoever, and all of a sudden it's 5-4, 2.5 to go here. Calgary now will look to try and put a halt to what is now a three-goal run. Game of run so far, as Calgary had a five-goal run. Mammoth now with a trio of their own. Dixon has it for the Roughnecks. Dixon passes off. Actually, Stewart got in the way of that one briefly. Now Dixon gets the return pass. There's a shot by Dutch, handled easily there by Dylan Ward, and now the Mammoth, who are not afraid to run and gun. This time we'll let the offense go to work 5-on-5 with under 2 minutes to go here in the second quarter. As they work it from the far side, there's a shot, scores! Ryan Lee again! It's 5-5 on three straight goals where the Mammoth have just been all alone in front of DelBianco.
Yeah, yet again, Lee just slips in behind the defense here and puts it in over top of DelBianco's shoulder and ties the game. Kurt Miloski has the challenge flag out. We'll see what he does with it. No, back in his pocket, as Ryan Lee stayed out of the crease on that play. And now a tie game,
just
as it's
been
three goals in the last couple seconds here for the Mammoth, as they tie it up at five.
Now Burton trying to control the faceoff. Ball rolling all over the place, and it'll be the Mammoth, pardon me, it will be the Roughnecks who get possession here.
Yeah, on the loose ball push, Manning will take it.
So Calgary needs to take back the momentum here, as Colorado has taken over here in the second quarter. Here's Dixon with it, try to find that corner. Missed, Taylor recovers the loose ball, 15 to shoot now. Taylor now leans on his check. Now Dobie has it. Dobie's pass is almost picked off by the defender right in front of him, and eventually the Mammoth do recover.
Yeah, again, active sticks, active defense, and a more aggressive defense has been the Mammoth's plan here, seemingly in the second quarter, and it's worked to perfection as they've come out, tied the game on the offensive side of the ball, and really have held the Roughnecks at bay, just allowing one goal in this quarter.
Now the Mammoth looking for their first lead since leading 1-0. Pass doesn't work, off the end wall. Bounce shot in, also wide of the net. That'll be a 30-second violation. Salama picks it up now, has help, has numbers, there's the shot, nice save by Dylan Ward off of Riley Lowen. With now 32 seconds to go here, the Mammoth look to push the action down the floor. to get one more opportunity. I think they're going to call timeout and draw something up here.
Yeah, it looks like the head coach, Pat Coyle, is looking for one final play. About a 2 second difference between the shot clock and the play clock.
But a stunning turn of events here. Again, it felt like a game the Roughnecks were really controlling, but you could kind of sense the energy level dipping, Ryan. And then the Mammoth, again, three straight goals, and each time just complete defensive breakdowns by the Roughnecks.
Yeah, absolutely. All three goals featured a Mammoth player just all alone on the top of the crease before they put it in. And those three goals coming in just 1 minute and 4 seconds after a 9 minute or a 10 minute lull with no goals in the second quarter. The Mammoth come out and score three in a minute four to get this game back. So the Roughnecks, as you mentioned, Grant, looked like they'd been carrying the play for the majority of the first half, but you take your foot off the gas for a minute in this league, or in this case, a minute and 4 seconds, and all of a sudden, all of that hard work that you've put in the first half is evaporated, and you're back to even Steven.
Well, and shots on goal, 24-19, favoring Colorado. I mean, I think Calgary definitely was the better team, but their offense has really sagged here in the second quarter, not getting nearly the number of shots or high-quality chances on Colorado, and the Mammoth here should have final possession. There's about a one-second differential. So indeed, Ward looks to the bench now as he starts to walk towards there, and we'll see if they go with the 6-on-5 here, as right now he's going to stay back in there. And now the Mammoth start to move it around. McLaughlin with it. McLaughlin passes off now, just two to shoot. That shot's blocked. Calgary picks it up, but the clock will expire and we'll head to the locker room. 1-1, the score, pardon me, 5-5 the score here between the Roughnecks and the Mammoth as we reach the intermission, Ryan. A tale of two games in one half, I suppose.
Yeah, tale of two quarters certainly here, as it was a 4-1 quarter in each direction, as the Mammoth pick up a 4-1 quarter in the second to get back to 5-5 after finding themselves down 4-1 to end the first. And the Mammoth again got all that work done in a minute and 4 seconds, scoring three goals, but they are on a four goal run here before they get in. And it looks like Kayla is down with the man of the hour from the first quarter, Dane Doby, who scored his 400th goal. Kayla?
I'm here with Dane Doby. Dane, you told me before the game you didn't really want to talk about the milestone because you don't have the goal yet. You now have 400 career goals, all with the Calgary Roughnecks. I'm going to ask you, what's it like once you reflect on all of those milestones?
It's a great to play here, to be honest, and I played a long time in Calgary. I play with a lot of great lacrosse players, but right now, this season, we got to get this season series, and we need a big win here tonight.
It's a tie game going into the half. That means it's going to be an explosive second half. What do you guys need to do to gain control again and gain that lead again?
We have to play like we did in the first quarter. I didn't think we had a good second quarter. We just got to keep going and, you know, grind it out and keep playing hard. This is, like I said, season series. We need the crowd behind us tonight.
Thanks a lot for this. Congratulations on the big goal.
Thanks.
Thanks, Kayla. Calgary and the Colorado Mammoth tied 5-5 at the halftime here. You're watching the National Lacrosse League right here on BR Live. Five-five, the Roughnecks and Mammoth tied at halftime. When we're watching these games, it can be hard to remember that these players do a lot off the floor as well. The Philadelphia Wings' Kevin Crowley is a player who has built programs dedicated to teaching boys and girls the game of lacrosse. The NLL's Devin Caney caught up with Crowley to talk about his relationship with the City of Brotherly Love on and off the field.
So how long have you lived in Philadelphia now?
This will be 7 years, going on 7 years now.
You're from?
New Westminster, outside Vancouver.
That's pretty far away.
Yeah.
But what was it about Philly that made you want to stay?
couple different reasons. We started my company, Fusion Lacrosse, here about a year into me initially moving here, and then, you know, kind of fell in love with the whole the sports scene here, cheering for the Eagles, Flyers, Sixers. And
are you a Philly sports fan now?
Oh yeah, big time.
Okay.
Yeah. And then the concert scene and everything, the music here is great, so it really is a lot to love in this city.
Yeah, we were talking earlier about spending a day in the life of Kevin Crowley, and you're pretty busy. So I want to talk about your relationship with the city of Philly off the field, because you mentioned Fusion.
Yeah, so Warhorse started, I was coaching at St. Joe's University when I first came to the city, and there was some players playing around on the field after, so I went over and I, you know, asked about what their program, and a guy named Arthur Johnson, goes by AJ, he was running essentially a program for inner city kids to, you know, get exposed to the game of lacrosse and, you know, use that to hopefully have some really cool opportunities that they might not have otherwise. So it's a little different than Fusion, where it's out in the suburbs. This is, you know, mainly in the city. I feel pretty fortunate for the position I'm in and getting to do what I love, playing lacrosse, coaching lacrosse, so I wanted to give back. We actually, that same day, I met a player, Amir Fluellen. He was a West Philly kid, came to Shipley, and then ended up getting a scholarship to go to school and play lacrosse there. So, you know, it's success stories like that that, you know, keep me involved and engaged, and I want to see more of that happen.
I've been living in Philly for 7 years, basically local. I'm going to hit you with some Philly trivia.
Now I'm nervous.
First question. Who did the Phillies just sign, and you get bonus points if you know the contract details?
Bryce Harper, 13 years, $330 million.
What Sixers player attended Duke University?
JJ Redick.
What was the final score of Super Bowl 52?
Oh no. 38-34, 28-24, nowhere near?
No.
43-38.
41-33, Eagles. What movie starring Sylvester Stallone was set in Philly?
Come on, really? These are the softballs. Rocky.
All right, I have another one. Improvising here. Who is the actor?
Mark Wahlberg.
No.
Oh, I thought you were gonna go Invincible.
No.
On me.
What's the name of the third string quarterback for the Eagles?
Darn it. Mark Sanchez, butt fumble.
No.
Okay, I don't want any questions I don't know the answers to, and we're gonna cut the Super Bowl question score out.
It's boring if you know all the answers.
Calgary Roughnecks and Colorado Mammoth in a tight one tonight at Scotiabank Saddledome, tied 5-5. At halftime. And now Dan McCrae talks about what it means for him to be the captain of the Calgary Roughnecks.
I didn't know what lacrosse was until I was at like a hockey tryout. I think I was 6 or 7 years old. And there was a gentleman just walking around hockey tryouts in town and just going up to parents saying, hey, I think your kid might be good at this sport. I want to give you a kind of a quick presentation about it. So nobody in my family ever played lacrosse before, but thanks to a gentleman by the name of Rob McDougall. He introduced the sport to myself and a lot of other players. And he was my coach from Tyke all the way up through midget. From starting from my minor lacrosse career, I was always with one organization. And I've always kind of, you know, tried to keep with a group of guys, a lot of guys from my minor team. After we were done midget, we went to Junior B together. We won a Junior B Founders Cup championship. Then we all moved up to Junior A together. It makes me think of lifelong friendships that I had, you know, growing up. In Oakville, playing with the same organization, having the same coach the whole way up, makes me think of, you know, being taught how to play the game the right way. I remember being one of the little kids in the old Maple Leaf Gardens, waving their shirt around their head when Caleb Toth scored the, you know, the goal with like a 1 second left to win them the Champions Cup. And I, right then and there, I'm like, you're hooked. How are you not hooked? Well, after watching that, sport of lacrosse has taught me a lot of good lessons, and I owe a lot of people because of that. I guess for me, it's all I know for playing in this National Lacrosse League. And from the first practice or training camp I remember being at, something that really stuck with me was, I believe it was Kurt Miloski, even though he's an assistant coach at the time, he said, once you're a Roughneck, you're always a Roughneck. It's very humbling, walking out of the room with that, with a letter on your chest, for this organization. So I couldn't feel luckier to be with this a team and this organization for this long, and to be in the shoes that I'm in at this time. It's great.
BR Live is brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com to see how much you could save. Welcome back inside Scotiabank Saddledome. My name is Grant Farhall with Ryan Ballantyne. 5-5 as we get set to start the second half here between the Colorado Mammoth and the Calgary Roughnecks. And Ryan, again, a tale of two quarters, really, as the Calgary Roughnecks dominated that first quarter, looked to be in control, and then that all changed.
Well, it was the Colorado Mammoth opening the scoring as Robert Hope got a transition opportunity, and he was able to put it in. And after that, the Roughnecks offense took over. Curtis Dixon with a stuffed goal. Dan Taylor would add another one later. And as we see here, again, just moving the ball effectively, passing and shooting on those one-timer attempts as Reese Dutch picks up a goal. And, of course, Dane Doby with career goal number 400. And you can see the smile on his face as he got that one. But then after that, it was all Mammoth in the second quarter as Killen would get them to two goals. And then a run of three goals in a minute and 4 seconds for the Mammoth to close out the first half and bring it back to a tie game. So a game of runs here as the Roughnecks scored five in a row and the Mammoth close out the first half with four of their own, and really a solid performance here from the Mammoth to get back to even and continue this this momentum.
Kayla Spies is down on the floor with a member of the Colorado Mammoth.
Thanks a lot, guys. I'm with Dan Coates. Dan, you guys really pushed hard in that second quarter. You even got a goal. What do you guys need to do to continue that pace into the third and the fourth quarter?
We just got to stay the course. Obviously not the best start, but there's no panic on that bench. Our offense is coming. We got to keep pushing the ball and watch their threats. They got a good offensive squad there, and we got a lot of work to do in this third half here, or second half here.
You personally are coming off of a knee injury. I was just told by your Team Canada teammate, Jeff Snyder, how much you were missed this summer. How special is every game now that you're healthy?
Yeah, I think you just take nothing for granted. It's just going to be back with my teammates and competing, but I'm not taking anything for granted.
Thanks all for this.
Thank you.
Guys, back up to you.
Thanks, Kayla. Dan Coates and the Colorado Mammoth tied 5-5 against the Calgary Roughnecks. And checking some of the stats, Ryan, you can see Curtis Dixon 1-1, Reese Dutch 1-1, Dane Doby continues to be consistent 1-3. But the Mammoth doing a good job of keeping those big guns of the Roughnecks largely in check here tonight. Face-off contested and controlled by the Mammoth, so they'll get a chance to open the scoring here in the second half. Actually, they won't, because Bell climbs the ladder to pick that one off. It'll be the Roughnecks that get the first real opportunity here. Bell will give it to Dane Doby. Doby now skips down the floor, passes to Dutch. Dutch gives it to Dixon with 15 to shoot. Dixon now, his pass across to Doby is picked off and off to the races. In transition, breakaway opportunity for Gillis, shoots and scores. Jordan Gillis, and it's 6-5 Mammoth.
That's five straight goals now for the Mammoth as they get their first lead in the second half and their first lead since early in the first quarter when the Roughnecks were able to tie the game at one. And again, another transition opportunity. It was Coach Miloski in his interview with Kayla in the first quarter said this team is built on transition and power play scoring, and they've been able to do it in both those ways here tonight as the transition players have really come to play for the Colorado Mammoth.
That was a long pass across the floor and with not enough pace on it. And Gillis just stepped into the way of it and had a breakaway from, basically center all the way in. And now a face-off win again by the Mammoth as they're looking to pour on the momentum here. Rouet steps over center and around Courier. And now passes down to the corner. And the Mammoth now with 14 to shoot. Pass off. That's Lee, couple goals in that second quarter explosion. Now he's gonna head to the bench, just 3 seconds to shoot. Good defense here by the Roughnecks. Shot comes in right at the end of the 30-second clock. and no problem there for Del Bianco.
And Del Bianco closes the wickets and keeps it a one-goal game. Right now, the Mammoth out shooting Calgary, a 26-19 margin.
First lead for the Mammoth since they led early in this one, 1-0. So this is the first time the Roughnecks have trailed since early in the first quarter. That pass picked off again, as that time it was Capito stepping into the middle.
Yeah, a lot of active sticks after that first quarter. The Colorado defense playing very aggressively on the man, not giving the guys any room to breathe, and doing a good job of creating turnovers, as the Calgary defense just about did there.
Yeah, but they cough it right back up, and that'll give the Mammoth a fresh 30 there, as they did rule that Calgary had possession, if all that briefly. And now here's Killen with it. Couple moves there. He passes off to Whitting, and Whitting now has a man. Now pass into the high crease area. Vitarelli couldn't find it, and Del Bianco came way out of his crease to grab the ball. Now Dan McRae with it. McRae will pass off to Dobie now. 12:35 to go here in the third quarter. Colorado now leading 6-5. And now Dobie again gets a bit of a step. Dobie to the net. And a nice save there by Ward as he booted that one out there. Now Pace fighting for the loose ball. Dixon in there as well. But the Mammoth come up with it. Then a great attempt there by the Roughnecks. Pace to try and get it back. Couldn't. And as a result, it's Tim Edwards now for the Mammoth. Down there all by himself, waiting for help. Gets it finally by Wardle. Wardle rolls it over to the other side. And the Mammoth now only have 6 seconds on the shot clock, as it took them a long time to get everyone on the floor. Lee will just try his luck from way out there, hit the defender as Courier was all over him. And gives him a little extra whack for his trouble too. Lee looked towards the official
Maybe the official might have agreed with Zach Courier that Lee hadn't dropped the ball fast enough.
Well, so you could have given a delay of game or a whack or both, and in that case, neither. It probably all saws off the same way. Roughnecks now, shot from well out, scores! Curtis Dixon goes submarine style and ties the game at 6.
Well, I don't know how much room there was between Dylan Ward and the post, but Curtis Dixon found it on that one. As he fires, as you mentioned, that low submarine shot in the middle of a crowd. I mean, just threw three players and up into that top corner. Past Dylan Ward. Nice shot from Curtis Dixon through traffic and ties the game at 6 on his second of the night.
Yeah, first goal for the Roughnecks since 30 seconds into the second quarter. So that breaks a long drought on offense there for the Roughnecks. A big goal, and we're all tied up again, 6-6. Now Bell has it for the Roughnecks off the faceoff win. Calgary will look to reestablish a lead here. And the crowd back into this one now. They had gone silent after that long run by the Mammoth. 5-goal run is finally halted. Now Dobie tries his luck from well out. That is handled easily by Ward. And he handles the rebound as well. And now the Mammoth come back down the floor on offense. Rue has it. Rue passes off to Killen, who comes back to Rue. And now Whitting out there as the pair of rookies out on the floor for the Mammoth. Now there's a fake shot by McLaughlin. Couldn't take the ball with him, and Courier has it in transition. Has Dan McRae with him. The Mammoth get back on defense quickly, so Calgary will just go 5-on-5 here. Riley Lowen with the ball, has a man behind the net, gives it to him. And now Courier staying out there this offensive possession. His shot is blocked by Sullivan. Now Courier gets pinned in the corner, throws it towards the net, gloved by Ward. And he immediately throws it down the floor to Capito, who steps over center. As the energy picks up here in the third quarter, Lee has it for the Mammoth. Sidestep over the restraining line, has a man off the bench. That's McLaughlin now. McLaughlin behind the net. And that's played back on front. Nice save there by Del Bianco on the bang bang play. Vitarelli had that opportunity, but Del Bianco played it nicely. And now here's the Roughnecks, Dane Dobie. 9:35 to go here. Doby back to the defender. Look for that backhand chance. This time he's going to pass it off to Dan Taylor. Taylor now peels off, goes over to the other side. Ball is dropped by Dixon. Now he's trying to work around the defender. Does to the net and puts it off the post. The crowd buzzing on that rush by Curtis Dixon. And Calgary gets the ball back in a fresh 30. Dixon was down in a heap in the crease. Now he's back up. There's a shot save made by Dylan Ward. As the ball is caught in his equipment, but he fishes it out. 6-6 with 9:04 to go here in the third quarter. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
Can you fly this plane and land it?
Curtis Dixon has the goal for the Roughnecks here in the second half that tied the game at 6. And as you see here in his first 7 games, averaging about 2.5 assists per game with 16 shots. Last game, 8 assists, 8 shots, cut down his offense and really spread the ball around to the benefit of his teammates, and added his first ever career fight. And I can tell you, Grant, he was commiserating with me this week that he missed his opportunity for his first ever Gordie Howe hat trick, saying that all he needed to do was just score a goal and was unable to do so. But 8 assists in a 15-9 win last week for Curtis Dixon. He's got 2 goals here tonight.
The Mammoth tied 6-6 with Curtis Dixon in the Roughnecks, and with possession now looking to retake the lead here. There's a shot from well out on Del Bianco, no problem for him. Now looking down the floor, not afraid to launch those long rainbow passes, but this time he goes for the shorter release. And the Roughnecks now enter the zone. Dan Taylor with the ball. Taylor will pass off to Dutch. Dutch will give it to Dixon. Dixon now with a bit of room, passes to Doby. Doby now with Taylor on that side. Peels off one defender, was looking for Taylor, then looked towards the net. Nice shot and a good read there by Ward, as he took that one away from Dane Doby.
Yeah, the Roughnecks have really kind of gotten away from their passing offense that was working so well in the first quarter. Wanted to see an adjustment back to that style here the rest of the way.
Now the Mammoth looking for an opportunity, lead with it, sends it across to McLaughlin. McLaughlin looking towards that, takes the shot at Del Bianco, makes the save. Want all the latest news, interviews, and more delivered straight to your inbox? Head over to NLL.com and sign up for the NLL newsletter now. You will not want to miss a beat. Now here's Bell for the Roughnecks to Lowen, 7:35 to go. Lowen hangs on. There's a piece of lumber on the floor here. Looks like that's an owner of the Mammoth, so they're down a little bit there. That shot stays out somehow. And now it's played ahead quickly to Joey Capito. He's got numbers, but Calgary gets back on defense.
It was Taylor Stewart picking that ball out of the air on the rebound.
Now behind the net, quick play in front, scores! Ryan Lee with the hat trick goal, 7-6 Mammoth.
Yeah, nice play here from behind the net as the pass comes out in front to find a streaking Ryan Lee. And as you mentioned, his third of the game puts the Mammoth back up one here with 7:09 to go in the third.
Yeah, and he's had an impressive game here tonight. 3 goals and just showing a real nose for the net to find those soft spots in the defense. And Ryan Lee gives his team the 1 goal advantage back. So Calgary once again chasing here. Big battle on the faceoff as Burton and Edwards just go toe to toe, lid to lid. And eventually it's chalked back. And Courier, no surprise, swallows up the loose ball.
Now again, one of the league leaders in loose balls on the season, despite not being a faceoff guy. Faceoff guys normally get an inordinate amount of those loose balls off of every start.
Courier heading into the weekend just second in the NLL for loose balls, I think behind Jeremy Thompson, if memory serves. But again, as you know, Ryan, he doesn't take the faceoff, so it's really remarkable what he does in terms of piling up the LBs. Oh, big body check there, tossed aside. Was Riley Lowen. Cooler heads prevail, though, and The Mammoth now with 6:20 to go here in the third quarter, looking for what would be their first two-goal cushion in this contest. They've had a pair of, now 3 one-goal leads, but never more than that. Looking to change that on this possession if they can. And the ball just skips towards Del Bianco. I think that was intended to be a pass, not sure for who. Either way, he makes the save. And now Bell comes back for the Roughnecks. He'll give it to Dane Doby. Doby has Dan Taylor fighting for position down in front of the net area. Doesn't give it to him. Instead comes to Dixon. Dixon now already with a goal this quarter. Now trying to shake through a couple checks all the way to the net. Still with it behind the back shot, and Ward denies Dixon.
And a penalty coming up to Curtis Dixon as well.
And now in transition, another opportunity here for the Mammoth. There goes Ward to the bench, so the Mammoth will go with the 6-on-5 here. Rouet has it. That might be why they didn't take the shot on that transition opportunity, wanting to get the 6-on-5 advantage, although they now have just 5 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Here's McLaughlin around the defender. McLaughlin all the way, scores! Eli McLaughlin with a gorgeous effort. 8-6 Mammoth.
Well, you got to think that at that time, it was about time for Eli McLaughlin. Hadn't scored yet this game, the leading scorer for the Mammoth on the season. Nice move there, cuts in towards the middle, and a little dipsy doodle inside the far post stick side. And on that 6-on-5 opportunity, comes away with a goal and a 2-goal lead now for the Mammoth, who've really put it to the Roughnecks. At one point they were trailing 5-1, and they've outscored the Roughnecks 7-1 since that time, allowing just one goal in the last, give or take, 25 minutes of play, Grant.
Yeah.
And the defense has done a good job. Dylan Ward's been all over the place, and everything's gone right for the Colorado Mammoth.
Well, and I think that's the second time tonight they've scored on that 6-on-5 advantage. A delayed penalty, so.
Yeah, you're correct there.
I mean, again, it's been transitions, it's been power plays or the 6-on-5. That's how they're doing their damage, just like Kurt Maloski described it. But so far, the Roughnecks haven't been able to figure it out, and they've really gone dry on offense. Looking to change that here is Dane Doby. Just 3 to shoot, though. Dane Doby fighting through his check. Doby now double-teamed. It's a 30-second violation. So Calgary's offense continues to struggle to find opportunities here as they're down now 8-6. Against the Colorado Mammoth. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
All university and college students are invited to park. The Alberta Dental Association wants to remind all offense fans.
Well, the Colorado Mammoth found themselves in dire straits after the first quarter, trailing 5-1, and then all of a sudden an outpouring of offense from the Mammoth as they were able to put together 5 consecutive goals over the course of the second quarter and early in the third, including 3 in just a minute and 4 seconds, where they found themselves on the doorstep all alone on several occasions. And Robert Lee, part of that run as he picks up a hat trick. But you can see Gillies there on the transition opportunity. Lee with his hat trick goal there, and McLaughlin finishes off that run. Again, 7 of the last 8 goals in this game have been scored by the Mammoth. They lead at 8-6.
Absolutely. We've been talking about how important this game is for the Mammoth. It's a big one for them in that playoff race, but it's also big for the Roughnecks. They want to be in position. Another opportunity off the post is McLaughlin. To complete my thought, the Roughnecks trying to battle for a first or second seed with San Diego and Saskatchewan. A loss here would drop them back below the 500 record. So this one matters to both clubs, and right now it's the Mammoth who want it more as they lead this one 8-6 and they get the ball back here.
Yeah, and Saskatchewan in action tonight as well. They're hosting the Buffalo Bandits. That game tied at 5 at half.
At times Saskatchewan's been a little sleepy this season as well. Stuff attempt there might have had room, but the ball did not cooperate there for Wardle as he put it back over the net. 3:35 to go here in the third quarter. That has been carried by the Mammoth. The Roughnecks now try to inch within one goal here on this possession. Doby gets the ball. with 12 to shoot, swings it across to Curtis Dixon, who has the only Roughneck goal of this quarter. Dixon now passes off to Dobie. Shot blocked, then he's rammed against the end wall by Josh Sullivan. Dobie did not care for that.
No, the Roughnecks have had a couple words for the officials. This game getting a little rough out there tonight in the rough house, but both teams providing a little bit of the rough stuff. And so the referees letting it go, letting them play.
Ryan Lee was looking for another opportunity there as he nearly found himself, but couldn't get the pass, and then Calgary turns it over again. And the Mammoth will be happy to take possession back here. Calgary just a little careless with the ball here tonight. Now the Mammoth going to work offensively. Whitting has it, all sorts of moves there, but nice defense there. Now eventually it comes to Roue with nine to shoot. Turns and fires, and I think Del Bianco got a piece of that. Actually, it bounced over the net. Either way, the Roughnecks get possession and step over center. Eli Salama passes off now and heads to the bench, and now Calgary has Riley Lowen on the ball. 2:09 to go here, 19 on the shot clock. Lowen passes off to Dixon. Dixon now through two defenders. Dixon to the net, takes the shot, and Ward makes the save even as he was going the wrong way.
Yeah, nice stop here from Dylan Ward as Dixon tries to go five hole, but Ward able to get on top of it as he fell backwards. It squirted through, but not through enough. And another nice save there from Dylan Ward.
Yeah, who's been virtually unstoppable since early in the second quarter when Dan Taylor scored. Since then, just that one goal to Curtis Dixon. Now, potential numbers the other way for the Roughnecks in transition. However, they're going to pull up there as, again, the Mammoth have done a nice job of getting back on defense all night long. And now a double team turnover created there. John Lentz has it for the Mammoth. Lentz will pass off to Capito. And now he'll wait and look for a better option. Decides that Roue is that. Now down to 70 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. And the Mammoth looking for a three-goal lead. There comes the shot, saved Del Bianco. Rebound is there, and Courier finds it. Courier cuts through everybody over center, through a defender. And now we'll wait and get help. Riley Lowen with it. Lowen will pass to Dobie. Down to 45 seconds remaining in the quarter. Dobie spins off a check. Now at the corner, passes up high to Pace. Pace has been a little quiet here tonight. Now he tries to cut to the net. I don't know if that was a shot or a pass. It missed everybody. And with 32.1 seconds to go, it'll be Colorado possession.
Yeah, again, we've seen a lot of the one-man game here from the Roughnecks here in the second and third quarters. A lot of one-man opportunities as opposed to spreading out. And that may be as a result of the defense that Colorado's decided to play, a little tighter man-to-man defense. But nevertheless, the Roughnecks not doing near the passing they were doing in that first quarter.
So about 2 second differential between the game clock and the shot clock, so they'll keep the goalie in there. The Mammoth looking for one more opportunity here. That pass goes astray, and the quarter will wind down, and the Calgary Roughnecks are going to have to regroup here as they trail this one 8-6. As we head to the final quarter here, Calgary's got some work to do here in the final frame. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. The chase for the championship has begun, and only one team can be crowned champion. Be sure to catch all the action live as the playoff race heats up. Round one of the NLL playoffs begins May 3rd to 5th on VR Live. Both these teams tonight, Ryan, hope to get to the playoffs, and but as we take a look at the stats here, Colorado so far seems like they want it more.
Yeah, the Roughnecks were leading in the score clock and in the shot clock after the first quarter, and since then it's been all Mammoth as they've scored seven of the game's last eight goals to take an 8-6 lead and lead on the shot clock as well, 34-27. The only area the Roughnecks winning on that stat sheet tonight is the work of Tyler Burton and the 11 faceoffs out of 17 he's won. And you can hear the crowd here, 13,946 strong on this St. Paddy's Day party, rooting on the Roughnecks and hoping to stir them to victory as the Roughnecks would look to keep pace in the win column, at least, with the Seals and the Rush in the Western Conference and get themselves one spot closer to clinching should they complete a comeback. On the other side, the Mammoth, of course, looking to spoil the party here in Calgary for the hometown fans and give themselves a leg up against Vancouver for that fourth and final playoff spot in the West.
And the Mammoth get the first possession here of the third quarter, the fourth quarter, pardon. There's a point-blank opportunity. Shot goes wide of the net. And Calgary takes it back now, looking to get the offense back on track. Simpson now runs the floor. Simpson passes off. That shot is blocked by off the stick of Dutch. And the Mammoth come down the floor immediately. Led by Gillis, who's had a strong game, including that breakaway goal. Really part of that run that the Mammoth went on. And apart from a Curtis Dixon goal to interrupt that run, they'd still be on it. Now here's Wardle for the Mammoth. Spins off the defender. Now double team, gets hit to the ground. Ball is loose down there. Calgary's happy to let the shot clock expire and take possession back.
Yeah, as you mentioned, Grant, just one goal now in the last 30 minutes of gameplay for the Roughnecks since that 30-second mark of the second quarter when they got their fifth one. Curtis Dixon, the only person to solve Dylan Ward in the last half hour.
Well, and again, they scored 15 against the Rock a week ago. They scored four in the first quarter tonight and then just went dry. Just the two goals since. Dan Taylor tried his luck from way out there, couldn't get it on net. Now comes to Dixon, he misses by about 3 feet. So nothing working right now for the Roughnecks on offense. Lintz now passes and hands it off to the offense. McLaughlin had that beauty goal, the go-ahead goal in the third quarter. Now looking to get around the defender. Passes to the side of the net, but player in the crease gives Calgary the ball back. Salama with it. He'll run the floor with some room all the way to the net, takes the shot, and Ward makes a chest save.
And a nice stop there from Ward, sending the ball back the other way.
That's Edwards with it. Yeah, Ward since that first quarter has been really, really sharp in the Mammoth net. Vitarelli now with it. He'll pass off with 13 to shoot. Lee, nice pass in front, and a nice save by Del Bianco off of Wardle. And now here comes Simpson in transition, has Dobie ahead of the play, but I think he went early. He is not happy about that. But I think the Roughnecks are going to get caught here with a...
Yeah, and the other official warning, Dane Dobie, that he has seen just about enough as a legal substitution is the call for too many men. The Roughnecks will go back on the penalty kill as the Mammoth will look to extend their lead here on the power play. Well, yeah, Dane Dobie waved at the referee twice and the other referee indicating that he'd heard enough and didn't want to see anything more coming from 44.
1-for-2 on the power play are the Mammoth tonight. They do have another goal with the extra attacker on a 6-on-5. Now they work it around. McLaughlin gets it. Nice pass over to the other side, and Del Bianco denies Lee of his fourth of the night. Dan McRae all over that loose ball. Has Dobie ahead, somehow gets it to him. Dobie behind the back, and Ward denies number 44. That was a heck of a pass and a heck of a try.
Yeah, just receiving that pass from Dane Dobie, I mean, wowee.
Instead, though, it's still 8-6 and still 90 seconds to go. Now, McLaughlin thought he had a lane. Stick was checked just as he was about to release it. Went to the corner, but they recovered it there. Still 10 to shoot on the shot clock. Now McLaughlin again shoots, rebound is there. Del Bianco was well out of his net, but the Roughnecks recover it. And now they come down the floor with 65 seconds to go. There's a shot, scores! Eli Salama shorthanded. Well, Calgary back to within one.
That's a big goal there for Eli Salama, who came down and just put everything he had into that shot to go low on Dylan Ward. And as a result, brings the Roughnecks back within one. and again kind of breaks that momentum being carried currently by the Mammoth. As you see Salama there, his first goal of the season.
First goal of his career.
And first of his career, and he's getting a little bit of love from the boys on the bench as the shorthanded marker puts the Roughnecks within one.
So now the Mammoth, still on the power play for another 55 seconds, will try and erase that shorty as they go back on the 5-on-4, get an important faceoff win to retain the power play. There's a shot wide of the net, and that'll be over and back against Colorado and give Calgary a chance to kill off almost all of the remaining power play time.
And Zach Currier was trying to hustle down for the quick restart, but was unable to get down before the referee blew the whistle.
So instead, Calgary now has 30 seconds as of now, 22 seconds on the shot clock, so they can take this down to under 10 seconds. So they'll be happy to hold onto the ball here on the perimeter and just take that down as much as possible. Now they'll start to work it in. Dixon has it now, 8 to shoot, looking at a double team though. Dixon now behind the back pass all the way to Dobie on the other side, and he'll just roll it down to the corner. That gives the penalty kill unit a chance to get everyone on the floor here. And Kalinich is already on his feet, and now he'll exit the box and enter the fray. McLaughlin passes off. There's a pass looking for Wardle. That doesn't connect, and Calgary now back on the attack, down by one, looking for the tying marker. It's Curtis Manning with it. Manning to Lowen to Dobie in the corner. Dobie up high to Pace, now to Dixon with 15 to shoot. Dixon gets a Pace pick. There's a shot, nice save there by Ward. Rebound was available, but Pace couldn't find it. Big pile up in the crease there, but cooler heads are gonna prevail here with under 10 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. 8-7, the Mammoth hanging on to a one goal lead, but the Roughnecks back with some momentum. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
Tonight's same or saves, one, and then a lucky number, eight.
Well, Dylan Ward had some troubles in the first quarter as the Roughnecks offense was passing the ball around and getting it past him. But since then, he's been almost unbeatable, allowing just three goals since the first quarter, but had a stretch of about 30 minutes in which he didn't allow anything, or only allowed one goal by him, rather. And you can see here, just save after save after save as the Roughnecks kept coming down the floor and were leaving unsatisfied as Dylan Ward kept the door closed and kept it an 8-7 lead in favor of the Colorado Mammoth.
I would dare say that save on Dane Dobie on that long pass, basically denying Dobie of what I would think is a goal of the year candidate.
Yeah, I mean, possibly if Dane Dobie scores there, it certainly would have had an excellent chance of being our Geico play of the night and would have been one of those ones you might have seen on ESPN tomorrow morning.
Instead though, it's 8-7, Colorado still leading by one, looking for some insurance now. This trip down the floor, it's McLaughlin with it. He's become more dangerous as this game has continued. Gets the return pass, goes across the other side, looking for the return feed, but well defended there by Curtis Manning. And now it's the Roughnecks in transition. Dobie's already out ahead of the play, doesn't want the ball though. Tells McCray to slow it down, which he does. And now the Roughnecks. Dane Dobie directing traffic out there, really doesn't like what he's seeing, telling his line mates where to go. Now Dixon has it. Dixon finds Pace. Pardon me, that's Dutch with it. Now it's 5 to shoot. Dutch again. Shot, oh, was whistled just wide of that top right corner. And now here's Hope in transition with now under 9 minutes to go in a very tight game here that has the feeling of going right down to the wire. Ryan, we've seen a number of games between these two teams over the years go to overtime.
Yeah, Colorado and Calgary seem to like giving away a couple minutes of free lacrosse on a regular basis, whether it be in the regular season, in the playoffs.
Yeah, there's been a couple of those too. Simpson can't handle that pass cleanly. Picks it up though. And we'll now give it to Pace. Pace has Dixon, who in turn gives it to Taylor, who in turn delivers it to Lowen, back to Pace now. There's a shot, scores! Dane Dobie's second of the night. We're tied, 8-8.
Quick stick opportunity for Dane Dobie in the center of the floor, and he puts it past Dylan Ward to tie the game at 8, as we see here on the replay. Just a nice feed from Tyler Pace into where Dobie could only get it, and a quick one-timer beats the Mammoth goaltender. And you can see how fired up 44 is on a night where he scores 400. 401 is just as nice and makes it a tie game with 8:15 to go.
Number 30 on the season for Dane Dobie as he reaches that mark again. You can see there, Ryan, more emotion on that goal than on the number 400, because at this stage of the game, it's a big one. And that tells you all you need to know about Dane Dobie. He's about the team success, not the individual milestones. He's out there again with the ball.
Yeah, there's not much more you can say about Dane Dobie than that. Anytime you ask him a question about individual accomplishments, he wants nothing to do with it. It's about the team, and the team comes first. He plays for the crest on the front.
There's Dixon, a wicked shot in on Ward. Nice save. And now he looks down the floor, has Stewart in transition. Calgary gets back on defense. Stewart has a man off the bench, couldn't deliver it to him cleanly. That was Jacob Rouet, who might have had a good look there. Instead, he goes behind the net, 15 to shoot. Whitting has it now for the Mammoth. 7:30 to go here in the fourth quarter. Shots on goal, 38-34 now, as it's a little closer, and Manning was dumped. The Roughnecks get possession back. Here's Dobie with it. Dobie shoots off the post and up into the netting.
Yeah, that'll give the Roughnecks a fresh 30. It was an off-ball foul that Curtis Manning took a while to recover from that got the Roughnecks the ball back.
Now Dutch to Dobie. Dobie really acting as the forward general here tonight. You can just see him calling plays and directing traffic. Has the ball again. Out of Pace. Pace now looking to cut to the net. Didn't take the ball with him. Nice defense by the Mammoth. And they turn it over. And here come Colorado in transition. Under 7 minutes to go here in the final quarter. Lord with it for the Mammoth. Passes off to McLaughlin. McLaughlin with a bit of a step. Now he peels back. Nice pass behind the back. Goal!
Wow.
Gorgeous by Kyle Killen. 9-8 Colorado.
Wow, wow, wow. What a goal from Kyle Killen as he just takes it and goes over the shoulder through the legs of Christian Del Bianco and restores a one-goal lead on the 39th shot of the evening. Kyle Killen, his second of the night. What a beauty.
That's 16 on the year for the rookie as well. The Mammoth, you may argue, going through some rebuilding, a little more youth in the lineup this season, and certainly a part of that future is that young man, Kyle Killen. And he's given his team a 9-8 lead here. Comes with 6.5 to go here. Calgary once again now trailing. Calgary has enjoyed the bigger leads in this one, but the Mammoth have enjoyed more leads, I would say. Calgary's been chasing for the better half of this one now. And down by one once again. Here's Dutch with it. Dutch up high, gets it back. Quick shot and a nice save by Ward. It's through him. And Dixon is pleading that, I don't know if he thought the ball was in the net or what.
Well, I think Dixon is saying that the Colorado player may have grabbed it with his hand and not his stick, and he's got a really good case there, because that's not in his stick, that's in the player's glove. And Kurt Miloski saying he couldn't see it well enough to challenge it, but I mean, Curtis Dixon was right on top of it and he had a great view.
Now here's Burton ahead of the play. Burton is gonna peel off as Lord got back on D to take away what looked like it might be a quick strike opportunity for Tyler Burton. Now 5:27 to go here in the fourth quarter. Calgary down by one. Dutch has it again. Dutch now winds, fires, and Ward makes the save. Up with it quickly, looking down the floor. As now the Mammoth look for the transition. Josh Sullivan all the way to the net. Penalty upcoming to the Roughnecks. As Sullivan did a good job there of drawing the contact, and then he's decked again by Cummings. And we'll see what happens here.
Boy, Sullivan's in some trouble here. That left leg, he's not putting a lot of weight on at all. Trainer out there to help him. As we take a look at the replay. Yeah, well, look here. Yeah, you can just see his knee twisted up underneath him. As Courier came over.
I would say that the Roughnecks were lucky to get out of that with just the original penalty to Carnegie, but Sullivan now getting carried to the bench by a teammate of the trainer, and you just hope that he's okay.
Yeah, again, if we could see that replay one more time, Sullivan went down, and just his knee crumbled out from underneath him. And as we take a look here, you can see Courier comes over, and Sullivan twists, his ankle's bent out, his knee's in the wrong direction. I mean, Courier's on his ankle at that point. I mean, everything, all of the joints in his leg affected there, and he's right down the tunnel, and you hope that that's a tweak more than anything else for Sullivan as he took the weight, the full weight of Zach Courier
and
there.
And this is a penalty shot for Kyle Killen that they're awarding.
Yeah, on the holding call.
One-on-one with Del Bianco in there. Shoots it wide. So the score remains 9-8. And Ryan, that's almost better for the Roughnecks because they don't give up the goal, but they also don't give up the power play time.
Yeah, at this point, the time is the enemy. You're right. And if you take another 2 minutes off the clock, that puts it pretty close to the end of the game. So that penalty shot ends up working out for Calgary, but only because Killen doesn't score. The result works out for Calgary in that respect, but if Killen scores there, it becomes that much tougher a mountain to climb, despite the fact that you would have had two less minutes to do it.
So now face-off, won by the Mammoth. Ball played ahead. Coates draws the attention of a couple defenders, but makes a nice release pass. And now we're under 5 minutes to go here. The Mammoth, a goal here would not be a dagger, but it would make life very difficult for the Roughnecks. McLaughlin has it for the Mammoth. McLaughlin with a bit of a step on the backhand now, peels off, pass. Quick stick opportunity at the side of the net, turned aside by Del Bianco. Bell comes over, nice loose ball recovery there. Ahead of the play is Simpson. Simpson has room, Simpson all the way, shoots, and Ward makes a big save on the rookie to keep the score 9-8. The Mammoth lead by one. We'll wrap this one up when we get back. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
Four and a half minutes to go in this one, a 9-8 Mammoth lead, and the go-ahead goal from Kyle Killen is our Geico play of the game. And as we see here, just a nice shot over the shoulder, five-hole pass to Del Bianco. And that is the play of the game presented by Geico.
So Calgary down by one here. When play resumes, the Mammoth will have possession. And we'll try and get some insurance here. Nearly 14,000 fans here tonight at the Scotiabank Saddle Dome. Big crowd here, loud crowd, trying to urge their team on to victory. But it is the Mammoth who have the ball right now and the lead. 9-8, 4:10 to go, 15 on the shot clock for the Mammoth. Lee has a hat trick tonight. He passes off this time. McLaughlin goes back to him. Lee now hangs on, 7 to shoot. You can see Mammoth want to make sure they're killing clock here. Two shot in on there, wider than that actually. McRae recovers it for the Roughnecks, and now they'll start to head down the floor. They're going to have to make one of these possessions count. It's been difficult since they scored those four goals in the first quarter, just four since, but they need at least one more here to tie the game. Dixon wants the ball and gets it. Dixon now shoots, and Ward makes the save out to challenge Superman and has the rebound up with it to pass off now with 3:30 to go here. Coates hands the ball off to the offense. Here's McLaughlin again. McLaughlin to the net and scores. Eli McLaughlin with a gorgeous goal. 10-8 Colorado.
Diving across the crease, going to the far side on Christian Del Bianco, just past Eli Salama. A great goal there as we see it go in clean. And the coaches will certainly take a look at it, but there's no question on that one that Eli McLaughlin restores a two-goal lead with a gorgeous diving goal. And now the Mammoth looking to, again, they're in a dogfight for that final playoff spot in the Western Division. The Roughnecks in a dogfight of their own, looking to keep pace with the Seals and the Rush. And it's going to be a thrilling final 3 minutes here.
Well, McLaughlin was a little quiet for the first half of the game, but has scored two huge goals here in the second half. And Colorado now leads 10-8. Dixon with it for the Roughnecks. Dixon, that pass is interrupted briefly, recovered to Lowen. Lowen to Dixon with room. Dixon shoots off the bar as Dixon beats Ward, but can't beat the post.
You can hear the 14,000 fans in here oohing and aahing as Dixon hit the post.
Down to 240 now, Doby with it. Quick shot, easily handled, rebound, scores! Right, Dan Taylor puts it in the yawning cage, and we're back to a one-goal game.
Yeah, rare mistake here from Dylan Ward in this second half as he reached out to grab the rebound, and Dan Taylor was able to get it a little quicker as he missed it, taking himself out of position. And as a result, Taylor gets almost an empty netter there, Grant, to get it back within one, making a 10-9 game.
Pass one just back and forth, number 15 on the season, second of the night for Dan Taylor. And it's a big one as it's now 10-9. We talked about that sort of magic 10-goal threshold for the Roughnecks. It's right there right now, Ryan.
Yeah, they've only won one game with their opponent scoring 10 or more this season, and that was against Saskatchewan, who got a couple garbage time goals in a 17-12 Roughnecks victory earlier this year.
That's a big time save there by Ward off of Dane Doby, who had a 5-bell opportunity to tie this game. Instead, 10-9 remains the score, now down to 2:10 remaining. And the Mammoth with an opportunity here to go back by two. McLaughlin goes around the world. That's turned aside, but the Mammoth get the loose ball, and they'll be happy to take another 30 seconds off the clock. We're down to now under 2 minutes remaining in this one. McLaughlin has the ball once again. The leading scorer of the Mammoth now passes off. Clean look there. Del Bianco makes the save. McCray didn't have his stick, so Del Bianco comes out to get it.
Oh, and over and back is the call. So it'll be Mammoth ball again. They've taken, at this point, this will be their third straight shot clock reset in the zone as the Roughnecks find themselves down one.
So the Mammoth now with the ball. 20 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Vitarelli passes off. As we're down to now under 90 seconds to go, the Mammoth eking everything they can out of the clock. That shot goes wide. Still time on the shot clock. Behind the back stuff attempt. And what's the call? No call on the floor for a goal. It looked like it went over the goal line there.
Well, I'm not, it was bouncing around. We'll take a look here. It wasn't over the goal line initially, but then it started bouncing. And of course, if it does go into the net area, despite the net being dislodged, it would be a goal. I imagine we're gonna get a review here, and we are. We're gonna get a look at this, and it's gonna be the overhead cam that probably tells the tale, as the ball just has to go into what would be a goal for it to count as a goal.
Gives us a chance to remind you to join Devin Caney and Renee Washington this week, taking you inside the action on Inside the NLL. That's every Tuesday at 6 p.m. Eastern on BR Live.
So the ball is not in the net area there. And I don't know, maybe they're saying he might have stepped in the crease.
Ooh, he turns his ankle for one thing.
I mean, that's an athletic play and a half right there. So he's on the ground here and the ball's not in the net.
Yeah, eventually it rolls through. It was impossible to tell from the live action where everything was.
And he hit the post with his stick.
Yeah, you're right.
So he just doesn't get far enough, and then when he lands, I mean, the ball's not in the net right now, so referee's going to come out and say no goal.
Confident in that, are you?
Yes.
No goal.
Well, he doesn't say no goal, but he makes the signal. And that is as good as a, I believe it's a nudge is as good as a wink to a blind bat, I believe is the expression.
I've never heard that.
You need to buff up on your Monty Python, sir.
73 seconds remaining. Calgary down by one here. They're going to put Del Bianco on the bench. As this could be their last opportunity here, depending on what happens. So they need to make it count. Here we go. Dutch has the ball. He passes off to Doby. As we're down now to 1 minute, Dutch gets it back. Dutch winds, fires, and Ward makes a big save on a big shot by Reese Dutch. Del Bianco races back into his net. We're now down to the final minute. Here's a breakaway opportunity, but Rouet is going to peel off there. That's the smart call. There is about a 28-second differential, I believe, between the game clock and the shot clock, so Calgary should get an opportunity. There's a shot, scores! The dagger from Kyle Killen, 11-9 Colorado.
Yeah, a huge goal here from Kyle Killen with just 40 seconds to go. This one, I mean, that's a dagger, as you mentioned, but let's not forget, Grant, it was a minute and 4 seconds in the second half where the Mammoth were able to put together a three-goal run of their own. So not impossible here before this one is closed out to see a comeback. It's going to take some work, though. And you'll see Del Bianco right on the bench now as the Roughnecks just put all of their offensive players down on the floor. And you can bet that they'll be looking to tie this up on the faceoff dot.
They might put a second back on the game clock too, as it looks like that went in the net at 41. Which, of course, the Roughnecks want to squeeze every bit of time they can. And it is a goal. As of right now, it's 40 seconds exactly that they're showing. And maybe it's going to just stay that way. It looks like it is.
Yeah, that's when the whistle went. So Burton will need to win this one.
Chips it back. And it is, in fact, Colorado getting it, but they give it up right away. Dixon comes back and takes it. 30 seconds remaining, and Calgary's going to have to do something quick here. Pace over the other side. Oh, Doby put it wide. Pace gets the rebound there. Now down to 20 seconds. Pace takes the shot. Ward makes the save. Rebound is available. The Mammoth have it. Turn it over again. Taylor has it. And it's picked off by the Mammoth. As we're down to 10 seconds, that might do it. And there's a trip too as Capito went down in a heap.
I think he called a timeout.
There you go.
As soon as he got the ball, I think he yelled over to the ref, timeout. But he did go down hard. And Joey Capito is in rough shape, but he does manage to walk under his own power.
Yeah, there's going to be some ice after this
Mammoth
game, I would
bench.
Say.
Yeah, I think for both teams, there's been a substantial amount of rough stuff here. But with 10 seconds to go, this one and the timeout is all but over for the Colorado Mammoth. They'll get a win tonight. Dylan Ward will pick up his fourth of the season. And really just a solid effort here from the Mammoth as they were down 5-1 in this game and outscored the Roughnecks 10-4 the rest of the way.
Ward sends it down the net, almost put it in the
net. You got to think Dylan Ward was thinking goal for sure.
Yeah, he had it on the right range too, but he'll take the win instead as he leads his team to an 11-9 victory over the Calgary Roughnecks, erasing that 5-1 lead at one point, and full value, Ryan, for this win.
Yeah, absolutely. The Mammoth were strong defensively, offensively. They got the job done with 11 goals on the night. Kyle Killen has the hat trick and really, put it to bed late. Absolutely. As with 30 seconds to go or 40 seconds to go, he scores his third one of the night and gets that one to end it off.
Your final score, 11-9, the Mammoth over the Calgary Roughnecks as they get a big win in their chase for the playoffs. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
Welcome back to the Scotiabank Saddle Dome, where the Colorado Mammoth beat the Calgary Roughnecks 11-9. I'm with the player of the game, Kyle Killen. Kyle, you had a hat trick, but let's talk about that last goal, the insurance goal, 40 seconds left. Can you describe it for us?
I was just trying to get open. You know, we weren't really trying to score, but they said, you know, if you're open in front, take the shot. No, I was just happy to get open in front there.
Talk about the resilience of your team tonight. You guys were so hungry coming into Calgary. And then that second quarter, everything just changed for you guys, and you guys kept pushing and pushing.
You know, every game that we've played, we've had that little chip on our shoulder. But, you know, we've been struggling a bit lately. And, you know, finally tonight, we just put it all together, and we're going to show the league what kind of team we can be.
Thanks all for this. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Guys, back up to you.
Thanks, Kayla. Yeah, Ryan, we talked off the start of this game that really this Mammoth team was looking for offense, starved for offense, and tonight they got it from that young man, Kyle Killen.
Yeah, Kyle Killen comes in tonight with 3 goals and 2 assists for 5 total points on the night, and he just had a phenomenal night's work. The first one was what started the run for the Mammoth, the second goal of the game for them. A behind-the-back dazzler that ended up being our play of the game from Geico. And then, as you mentioned, the dagger there. He also had a penalty shot in this game where he missed wide. So that one really must have felt good to get that insurance goal and secure his team a victory here with his hat trick of the night.
As their fourth victory of the year for the Colorado Mammoth as they move to 4-8. They've got a couple of big games coming up against the Vancouver Warriors in the race for that final playoff spot in the Western Division. Ryan, for the Calgary Roughnecks, we thought that last week was a turning point for this team. An impressive win over the Toronto Rock. Looked like they were finally going to get on a roll, particularly when they went up 5-1 in the first quarter of this one, and then they just went dry the rest of the game.
Yeah, the rest of the way, it became a lot of one-man effort. This team is at their best offensively when they're moving the ball, when they're passing the ball, and they were just not doing that through the last 3 quarters of this game. We also saw that they were really, and credit the Mammoth defense for that too. They were very aggressive. They were on the ball. They weren't allowing any space to the Roughnecks offense at all, and really they dominated defensively, and Dylan Ward was there to make the stop, allowing 1 goal in a 30-minute stretch at one point. Dylan Ward was phenomenal tonight as well.
So the Calgary Roughnecks fall back under 500, 6-7 now is their record, and they will next play in San Diego as the battle in the West Division continues in the National Lacrosse League. Once again, the final score 11-9, Colorado over Calgary. Visit NLL.com for an all-access pass to the National Lacrosse League and get the latest news, highlights, stories, and more. For Kayla Spies and Ryan Ballantyne, I'm Grant Farhall. You've been watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live.
You have been watching a special presentation of the National Lacrosse League.